Hello and welcome to this video on the exciting launch of Starlink in Nigeria. My name is Damilare Oladele. In a world where internet access is becoming more and more crucial for education, commerce, and daily life, Starlink has arrived to revolutionize the way we connect. Starlink is a satellite-based internet service provider provided by SpaceX, and it's finally available in Nigeria, bringing high-speed and low-latency internet access to remote and rural areas. In this video today, we are going to explore together the impact of Starlink in Nigeria and how it is changing the game for internet access and what the future holds for this exciting technology. Get ready to learn all about Starlink in Nigeria. Elon Musk's satellite company SpaceX is now available for customers in Nigeria. Nigeria is the first country to enjoy this facility in the whole of Africa. The company has also slashed the costs of its hardware and subscription plan to 274,098 naira and 19,260 naira monthly, respectively. This means that the hardware is going to cost a whopping sum of 274,000 naira and 98, and then the subscription is going to cost you 19,260 naira monthly. The company has announced that interested customers could pre-order the starter kits at the price of $600 for the hardware and $43 per month. Starlink is available in your area. Customers in your region typically see download speeds of 50 to 200 megabytes per second. No contract, 30 days trial. Some Nigerians who pre-ordered the hardware last year paid the initial amount in dollars, but the company's prices are now quoted in Naira, which means that Nigerians can make payments using their Naira debit cards. The Federal Minister of Communications and Digital Economy of Nigeria, Isa Pantami, has stated that Nigeria has achieved 100% broadband coverage with the operation of Starlink, whose satellite service covers the length and breadth of the country. According to him, through the National Broadband Plan, Nigeria was targeting 90% broadband coverage by the year 2025, and this has been achieved ahead of time through the licensing of Starlink, as Nigerians can now have access to high-speed internet from any part of the country. Now that Starlink has been launched in Nigeria, what are the important information you should keep in mind? Starlink has been granted an international gateway license, which permits the company to build, own, operate, maintain, and utilize an international gateway for offering and managing international access and gateway services in Nigeria. This license permits Starlink to provide services such as global mobile personal communication by satellite, mobile radio service, VSAT services, internet node and backbone services. In this space, Starlink will be facing competition from companies such as Globalcom, Pressed Cable, Satellite TV Systems, IMBIL Telecom Solutions, to mention but a few. It is also worthy to note that Starlink is going to face certain challenges in Nigeria. While Starlink has the potential to bring much needed internet access to many parts of Nigeria, there are a few challenges that they are going to face, and they include the internet coverage. Starlink is still in its early stages of deployment and may not yet available in all parts of Nigeria. And when I say all parts of Nigeria, you understand that we have different areas. We have the rural parts of Nigeria. We have the core villages where the internet facility might not be accessible from. Another thing that is going to be a limitation or challenge to Starlink is the cost. While Starlink aims to provide affordable internet access, the cost of the satellite terminal and monthly service fees may still be too high for some people in Nigeria, especially those who are living in rural areas with limited financial resources. Another challenge and limitation is competition. Starlink will have to compete against well-established internet service providers in Nigeria, who may have a more established infrastructure and more customer base. Hence, Starlink will need to differentiate itself in terms of quality, reliability, and affordability to attract more customers. Another challenge is government regulation. Starlink may face regulatory challenges in Nigeria, as the government may have strict rules and regulations regarding the use of satellite technology. The company must comply with regulations to ensure a smooth and successful deployment in Nigeria. Having said all that, is there any competition threats? Yes, there are competition threats. While the offer of Starlink is very lucrative and enticing to many people, they met a huge competition in Nigeria market already. Here are some of the competitions Starlink will need to battle with in the Nigeria market space. Globalcom Limited, EMTS Limited or Etisalat Nigeria, Hyperia Limited, Yugo, Cobranet Limited, Globalcom, and finally Gateway Telecoms Integrated Services. I might not have mentioned all of them. Of course, you know that the list is not exhaustive. You also need to get familiarized with the benefits of the competition. What intense competition in the market leads to is that it causes operators to reduce their prices as they compete for more and more customers. So my humble advice to Starlink is this: if Starlink decides to compete based on price, it will greatly benefit internet users in Nigeria, comparing their quality of service to other existing service providers and operators. With Starlink's satellite services, Nigeria will now have the opportunity to close the access gap, especially in rural areas that are not currently being served by other operators. Starlink is a low-latency broadband internet system designed to meet the needs of consumers in rural areas with low internet penetration worldwide. In terms of speed, Starlink has the potential to deliver internet speeds of up to 150 megabytes per second anywhere on the planet. This will definitely put pressure on other internet operators in Nigeria to improve their broadband services and increase their speeds so that they can remain competitive in the market. If you are interested in using Starlink in Nigeria, how do you get their facility? To order Starlink in Nigeria, you will need to do the following. The first thing you will do is to check coverage. And how are you going to do this? You are advised to visit the Starlink website, which is www.starlink.com, and enter your address to determine if Starlink is available in your area. If Starlink is available in your area, the next thing you need to proceed to do is to purchase a terminal. Starlink requires a satellite terminal in order to receive the internet signal. You can purchase a terminal through the Starlink website or through an authorized reseller. After that, you need to place your order. Once you get a terminal, you can now place your order for Starlink service through the Starlink website. You will be asked to provide basic information such as your name, your address, and also you'll be asked to select a package that meets your need. And after then, you are going to be faced with the issue of installation, which is not a big matter. After you place your order, a Starlink installer will be in touch to schedule an appointment for installation. The installer will ensure that the terminal is properly positioned and connected to receive the signal. And after you meet all these requirements, you are now free to start enjoying high-speed internet. Once we install these facilities, you will be able to enjoy high-speed, low-latency internet access with Starlink. You must also note that the availability and cost of Starlink may vary depending on your location, and the information provided in this video is subject to change at any time. It is best for you to check the Starlink official website for the most up-to-date information on ordering and installing their facility in Nigeria. In conclusion, The launch of Starlink in Nigeria has the potential to revolutionize internet access in the country, especially in rural areas that have been previously underserved. My recommendation is that for those who are interested in subscribing to Starlink, you should monitor the company's website for updates on availability in your area. Also, you must consider factors such as the network coverage, reliability of the network, and also the cost of the facility. If you are interested in finding out more about Starlink and its capacities, I recommend that you visit their official website using the URL that is showing on the screen right now. You can also stay informed about the latest developments in the world of satellite internet by following technology and satellite industry news. If you are watching this video for the very first time, or you have not yet subscribed to this channel, please kindly hit on the subscribe button and also click the notification bell so that you get notified as soon as I post other valuable videos like this one. In summary, the launch of Starlink in Nigeria represents a significant step forward in providing access to affordable and high-speed internet to the populace of the country. Whether you are in a rural resident or you live in an urban area, Starlink has the potential to bring the benefits of internet to you. Thank you very much. I remain my humble self, Damilare Oladele, and I hope to see you in another video. Stay tuned.